To make a portrait fit in a dialogue bubble or draw a cool flame in a help bar, you need to clip visuals to a limited area. This is typically called a clipping mask. In Godot 4, all it takes is one click. Well, two, technically. How to draw the mask, how to set up the nodes, and how to clip, you will learn it all in this video. Ready? Let's go. This video is sponsored by Godot game devs like you who invest in learning with GD Quest. Remember, throughout early access, you can start following our Godot 4 courses below launch price. A clipping mask consists of taking the opaque and transparent parts of an image, like this circle, and transferring that information to another image, clipping it to the shape of the mask. In Godot, you can use any image as a clipping mask. Whether you draw it in Inkscape, Krita, or GIMP, anything works. For this demo, I created a flat white circle and rounded rectangle in Inkscape. Using white lets me recolor them easily in Godot. I exported the images as PNG files directly in the project. Let's now see how to set up clipping masks in practice. I have a scene with a static sprite, an animated character that has a complex hierarchy with many sprites, and a circular area in which I want to clip the character. So I want to be able to place them inside of there and animate them without the characters going outside of the circle. The first thing I'm going to do is add a new sprite that will serve as the area to mask the characters, to have a nice border around the circle. And I'm going to scale this circle. I'm using a white texture to be able to recolor it easily. So for that, with the sprite selected, I go to Visibility, Self-Modulate in the Inspector, and then click the color and change it to anything. So I'm going to use my palette here and change it to a dark blue. Then I'm going to move the frog above the circle, and well, I'm going to put it on the side just so we can see the clipping effect. The first thing you want to do to activate clipping masks is to reparent your sprite or your 2D nodes as a child of the mask, because the clipping mask will affect children of the node. So in the scene doc, I reparent the frog to the circle mask, and then I select the circle mask node, and in the inspector, in the visibility category, go to clip children and change the option to clip plus draw. And instantly we can see that the frog is being clipped to the sprite. Cool. So now you can animate it, and you never have to fear that the sprite here is going to go out of the circle. I'm going to do the same with my character. So Lucy, I'm going to parent her as a child of the mask. And because clipping is turned on and she's outside of the circle, she's going to disappear. So I'm going to move her in frame, and voila, you can see it's working like a charm. The cool thing about that is you can use as many sprites or effects or particles as you need. So for example, I can add my frog here and move it to be above my character, and my character now has a mask as well. Not the same kind of mask, but you get the idea. So you can mix, match, and combine nodes. And as we've seen with the character, if I turn on editable children to see the hierarchy, you can even use very complex hierarchies of 2D nodes with skeletons and animations. What's important in my experience so far is that the nodes don't use different Z indices. So for example, if I were to select let's say the body of the character here, and I go to ordering and I change the Z index, you will see that it falls out of the clipping mask. This is kind of a limitation. So if you need to do that, if you need to have a complex setup with different Z indices in an animated character, then you will want to use a sub viewport to render the character to a texture and display this texture on a sprite that is flattened out. There's more that you can do with clipping masks. There's one more option. First, in the inspector, if I select the circle mask and go back to the clip children property, I can change it to clip only. This will make the character clip and give me this nice border at the bottom, but it will not draw the background shape. Now I can rotate and move my character, and it gets clipped to the area that I wanted with a really nice look, but it doesn't have an extra background. Here's one more thing that you can do. I'm going to reparent the character to show you that. It's use any kind of image with any kind of transparency as a mask. So here I have a flame shape, for example, and it has this softness around it. See what it does when I apply clipping masks to it with my character. So I'm going to parent my character to the flame shape, select the flame, and go to visibility, clip children, clip plus draw. And now I get this eerie effect where my character is visible through this shape with a sort of glow. So you can use that to have a character face appear like to make a ghost or something like this in your game. This last demo shows that you can use the feature with user interface and visual effects. I have a bar that's using a texture rec node and a bunch of particle effects and flames that are animated with shader materials that we coded. And if I select the bar fill at the texture rec node and set clip children to clip plus draw, you can see that now everything clips to the bar. It respects the rounded corner of my user interface and I get the animation I want. And I can move the flames and, you know, kind of try to prototype my visual effect like this. For an energy bar that's overflowing or something like this. For those of you learning on GD School, our new interactive learning platform dedicated to game dev, we'd love your feedback on the new edtech we've developed. As promised, both the 2D and 3D courses are already in early access with new modules dropping every month. If you have any questions, let me know in the comments, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.